नमस्ते एवरीवन एंड वेलकम टू द न्यू एपिसोड ऑफ ब्रेकिंग इट डाउन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट पंजाब्स कांग्रेस क्राइसिस। नाउ देयर इज नो डायरेक्ट क्राइसिस हैपनिंग इन पंजाब। द गवर्नमेंट इज स्टेबल, द चीफ मिनिस्टर इज केपेबल। हाउएवर द न्यूज इज दैट देयर इज एन अपकमिंग रिवॉल्ट इन साइड द पंजाब स्टेट कांग्रेस यूनिट एंड देयर इज अ हिस्ट्री ऑफ दिस मूवमेंट for Punjab's Congress Unit, and the history starts in 2017. 2022 was the year when Punjab is next going to elections. So is Uttar Pradesh. So 2017 was the previous election. 2017 also was the year when Navjot Singh Sidhu entered the Indian National Congress from shifting to BJP to the Indian National Congress. Now when he came into the fold of Congress, he was given an upstart, and that is the accusation of many people from the Amarinder Singh camp. So let me just introduce you with the characters of this story or the whole setup. There's Rahul Gandhi, Sonia Gandhi, the Congress presidents, one ex-president, one is the working president. Then there's Captain Amarinder Singh, who is the Punjab's chief minister. And there's Navjot Singh Sidhu, who you see at the unfunny Kapil Sharma show, fake laughing and cracking very terrible jokes and making shero shayaris which have been given to him by some Hindi writers. So these things. So Navjot Singh Sidhu, but the earlier age or earlier generation knows him as a batsman or a Indian cricket team player. But currently he is a cricketer turned into politician, aspiring to become the Punjab's chief minister. There's no doubt in my mind that Navjot Singh Sidhu has a strong aspiration of creating his base constituency along or in Punjab. Now this is the difference. I'll be going into comparatives also. But 2017, Navjot Singh Sidhu enters the Congress, and then he starts working inside Congress and mostly in Punjab, because that is his home state. And the chief minister is upset with him. He was inducted into the cabinet earlier, but because of some differences, some accusations, some internal rifts between the chief minister Amarinder Singh and Navjot Singh Sidhu, he was stripped away from his portfolio, and he is now an ex-cabinet minister in the Punjab, of the Punjab cabinet. And from there, his revolt started. He started criticizing Captain Amarinder Singh, going soft on the Badals. Badal is the Akali Dal, SAD, Shiromani Akali Dal family. So the party, the family which runs Shiromani Akali Dal are the Badals. And Badals are also strong business people in Punjab. They are accused in various scams and other things, as any politician family is. And Punjab chief minister had promised that he will punish the Badals for all their misdeeds and corruptions in Punjab. However, Navjot Singh Sidhu says that Amarinder Singh has gone soft on the Badals, and that is why he has a problem with it. And then he has accused Amarinder Singh in various different scams, his style of functioning, his people around him in the Amarinder camp, so on and so forth. On one hand, this was happening. On the other hand, Navjot Singh Sidhu was demanding to be made into a chief or in a powerful position. He was asking Delhi being 10 Aurangzeb Road, to make him or to rehabilitate him. This is a very frequent word used in news analysis, which is rehabilitation. He was asking a position in party organization in a very powerful position. Now in party also, when your party is in power, chief minister has a very strong say in how party organization should be, because chief minister is de facto also the chief of the party in the state, because in one or the other house he is definitely the chief leader of the party in the legislative assembly or the legislative council. But even if he is not, even if there is only legislative assembly in states like Punjab, ही हैज टू हैव अ से इन द स्टेट पार्टी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन बिकॉज इट इज गोइंग टू हेल्प हिम. दैट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इज गोइंग टू हेल्प हिम विन द नेक्स्ट इलेक्शन एंड रिटेन हिज करंट चीफ मिनिस्टरशिप. राइट. सो अमरिंदर सिंह वॉज डेफिनेटली नॉट हैप्पी वेन नवजोत सिंह सिद्धू वॉज हिंटिंग टू बी अपॉइंटेड एज ए पावरफुल पर्सन इन पार्टी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. इवेंचुअली 2-3 days back, नवजोत सिंह सिद्धू हैज बीन अपॉइंटेड एज द पंजाब स्टेट चीफ, कांग्रेस पंजाब स्टेट चीफ, एंड अमरिंदर सिंह इज नॉट हैप्पी. दीज डायनामिक चेंजेस विच कैन क्रिएट मेनी प्रॉब्लम्स इन द कांग्रेस हैव बीन मेड ओनली टू सैटिस्फाई नवजोत सिंह सिद्धू एंड बैलेंस कैप्टन अमरिंदर सिंह विक. दैट इज वन अजम्पशन. सो माई फर्स्ट अजम्पशन विद दिस चेंजेस ऑफ अपॉइंटिंग नवजोत सिंह सिद्धू एज द पंजाब चीफ कांग्रेस चीफ इज दैट इट वॉज फॉर बैलेंसिंग कैप्टन अमरिंदर सिंह पावर इन पंजाब एंड ऑल्सो टू ब्रिंग अ फ्रेश फेस इन द पार्टी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एज टू सैटिस्फाई नवजोत सिंह सिद्धू हु वॉज अ न्यू कमर इन द पार्टी. Now, satisfaction of newcomers in the party is not an old trend. Recently, cabinet reshuffle happened in the union ministry and we saw that a lot of defectors to BJP from Congress were made happy by the BJP. They were satisfied and they were convinced by the union ministry or the central party leadership that yes, you are worth, you have some worth in the party. You are no outsider anymore. We have included you. So I think this was an attempt of the Congress to reassure Navjot Singh Sidhu that you are not an ordinary karyakarta of the party. Even if you have come from outside, you have this important role in the party organization. On the same hand, Congress has only 2 or 3 chief ministers remaining in India. One of them being Captain Amrinder Singh, who is fairly popular in the Congress party hold and also in parts of Punjab. He is not entirely unpopular or entirely popular. He is an average person. His popularity is average. Some people like him, some people don't like him. Of course, the Akali factions don't like him, but he is a fairly popular leader in North India. He has a fair experience in politics. Navjot Singh Sidhu does not have an experience in politics. Navjot Singh Sidhu does not have fair experience in fighting polls, which Captain Amrinder Singh definitely does have. So, my assumption is, Amrinder Singh was becoming a heavyweight in Punjab. He could have been a potential challenge to Rahul Gandhi or Priyanka Gandhi's leadership if push came to show that either it's Gandhi's or someone else. And if someone else was a choice, then Captain Amrinder Singh's name came in first 2 or 3 people that who could replace the Gandhis. Captain Amrinder Singh is a strong party leader. So to cut down on his power, or to let's say balance his power, and to reassure Sidhu, this step was made. Could this prove beneficial? Yes, but the contingency is that Sidhu and Amrinder should join hands. If they join hands, they work average harmoniously, then they can definitely succeed in winning Punjab's elections next year. Definitely, because Sidhu is also popular, Amrinder Singh also popular. Where Sidhu is unpopular, Amrinder Singh is popular. Where Amrinder Singh is not popular, Sidhu is popular. So if they will make a very good team only if they join hands. If they don't, then this entire party organizational reshuffle will go to the dustbin and Saad or BJP will come back as strong party formation legislative parties in Punjab. The negative side to it is, again with the contingency, that as I said earlier, chief minister has to have a hold on state party organization also, because that same organization is going to help him win next elections. So if Amrinder Singh wants to retain his chief ministership and rule Punjab in a fairly independent manner, then he should have a say in party organization. You cannot give a control to someone who is completely opposite to you, who is an internal enemy, who is an arch nemesis inside your organization. Because the party organization will work against the chief minister's victory. They will win, they will definitely work for Congress's victory. But today, the face of Congress in Punjab is undoubtedly Captain Amrinder Singh. So if you have the skill like BJP to ask for votes without a face and still manage to get 70 seats from three earlier, I'm talking about West Bengal, then go ahead with it. But Congress does not have this good experience except Maharashtra to fight elections without a face and still manage to get a decent victory. If Captain Amrinder Singh is not projected entirely as their leader, and if there's a confusion about who's going to be the leader, is there going to be a feud or something like that, it will definitely hamper chances of Congress. So this was my analysis for Punjab's recent Congress changes. I will come with these analysis and latest news updates to you. Keep watching Bharat Bhagya Vidhata and have a great night and take care of yourselves. These are difficult times. Jai Hind.